All right, so we have left Anmore Manor, and then we're going to Dean Emery's haunt. I think it's Emery Hollow. And then we're going to go see Christopher Weeks. Awesome, in Vancouver. So, yeah. We're going to hit, I think, 7 haunts tonight, today, starting now. And then a few more tomorrow on the way home. So, yeah, this is a very cool trip. I'm having a blast. Ken and Leela were awesome. They put Michael Myers in front of my door when I woke up this morning. So that was awesome. Great hosts. We had a great time chatting last night and this morning about all things haunt and Halloween. And it was very, very fun. So I appreciate the hospitality. Thank you. Thank you. All right. So I'm out here and I'm editing my vlogs for the Canada trip that I was on. And I'm on to day 2, and I'm almost at the end of day 2, and I noticed that I have not done a review of Anmore Manor, where I stayed on Friday night. I haven't gotten to my day 3 vlog yet, so I may have done it on there, and if I did, you'll never see this. But if I didn't, then you will see this. Ken and Lilia, because I've been pronouncing it wrong in the other parts of the vlog the whole weekend, have put on a show at their house that is just hands down one of the most amazing displays and walkthrough that I've seen in a long time. A lot of haunters will do a display and walkthrough, but they usually do a little less on the display because the walkthrough takes a lot more time. You know, they'll put tombstones out, they'll put some creatures out or some maybe an animatronic here or there. As you saw in the pictures earlier in this part, or wherever I put this, somewhere in between, right around here, you'll see pictures. The amount of detail in the display outside that walks you into the walkthrough, where it really is the first part of the walkthrough, actually, but from the road, it looks like part of the it looks like a display, and then the walkthrough is in the rest of the rest of the area. The amount of detail in just the front yard is just amazing. After this trip, Ken told me that they're going to rename their banjo player in the front there in that picture. They're going to rename him Troy, because in the last one, when I got to there in the last vlog, I used the Deliverance dueling banjos sound, music track, he uses the same thing, which is obviously the most famous, banjo playing the music out there. He has like 170 crows. He has 170 crows now, because he had 171. Oh no, this isn't the one. Sorry, it's still on. I think it's still on. The Jack and Jill, but he gave me a crow similar to this one, but his doesn't have bad wings. He gave me one of them as a parting gift, and I put it on my Jack and Jill statue, and that's where he'll live from now on. But yeah, 171 crows, and the funny thing was is he hasn't seen crows around his neighborhood in years, as he's been putting up all these crows. Just when I was there, there were 4 or 5 of them in the yard across the street pecking at the grass, getting supplies for nests. So he wonders if his fake crows have affected the crow mentality of that area. Back to another squirrel. Their haunt winds through the front yard up through a couple of movie sets that they procured, through some really cool steps and planks, to give you that definitely a bayou feel, because that's what the front is supposed to be. It's like a cannibal bayou area. And then you actually go into their house and into other parts of their house, which in the past, evidently, they have done quite an extensive walkthrough of their house where they've used almost the entire house, that you actually walk in, go downstairs, go outside, go up, and go back in the garage, and it's quite extensive. They wanted to actually live in their house this time, so they've shortened it to where it's in the living room and in part of the dining room there. But then you walk into their garage, and there are probably 5 or 6 scenes in the garage, and some very, very unique and creepy scares. And they are very effective scares. If you've noticed, last year I have the Wilbur costume or the Wilbur persona, and that's the old man mask. Well, they have that same mask, and I saw it last year when I was doing the Dead with Dave Awards as I am a judge for them, and so I saw that on there, and I was like, oh, that's Wilbur's at Anmore Manor. Ironically enough, I show up there next year, this year, just last weekend. And that's the drop panel that got me. He actually got me because of the way they set up the scare. Very effective, using distractions. And he got me totally. So Wilbur got Wilbur. it would have been funny if I would have brought my Wilbur mask. That would have been even funnier. I would have had to go back through and videotape that. But, you know, the things you think about after you get home from trips like this. The amount of detail and the amount of, again, passion and dedication to the haunt... definitely shows with those two. Their entire house is filled with stuff that's Halloween. Even the bedroom I slept in, as you saw with the pictures there, has Halloween stuff in it. Whether or not that stuff they just didn't put out yet, but he has more crows. I'll tell you that. He showed me where the boxes of crows are. There's more. I'm getting dings. Yeah, so we're on our way to our next haunt. We'll take some video of that since it's a yard haunt. The first two are yard haunts. And then we are going to a couple of actual home haunts tonight that are, have actors and all that kind of stuff. One of them we're going to see in the daytime, but the other one we're going to see at night. It's going to be an awesome trip. Day two, here we go. We're going to go over that cool bridge. Big issue.
Well, I appreciate you dropping by. It's nice to see some of the stuff you've been doing. And
oh yeah, I have a blast with it. But I figured it was time to. Another bridge. Fraser bridge. They have really tall bridges here.
this is kind of a cool thing they do, where different parts of the day, this middle lane will be open for us to go instead of that side. And then other times of the day, it's like this, where these two lanes are not ours anymore. Evidently, maybe at some point during the sometime, all three lanes would be ours, or all three lanes would be theirs. That'd be interesting. But we're heading to the Lions Gate Bridge. We're heading over to North Vancouver here. So we'll have to see. Evidently, there's very cool lions on both sides of the bridge that are cast in concrete. And they're very cool looking. So Christopher told me about those. So we'll hit those up here in a minute. And then we'll head over to Dovercourt Crypt, and then Haunted Edgemont, and then we'll be on a ferry. Yes! It'll be awesome. So, I got an hour and a half to be at the ferry, so we'll make it. Oh, I see them. That's cool. Oh, Fenderbender. Fenderbender. Oh, I guess I didn't need to have the music on during that. Uh-oh, Fenderbender. Couple cars. Anyways, bridge. Super cool bridge. Ooh, bridge. Bridge. I love their bridges. They have great bridges here. They have cool bridges in Portland too, but these are long bridges, where Portland has short bridges. We have the Bridge of the Gods, which is really cool. It's out at Cascade Locks, but I love these long bridges. They're very cool. Alright. Here we go. Oh, see, now we could be in this lane over here, but nobody's in it. It's weird. Oh, car behind me is going to come in a minute, but yeah, that's cool. Site of the Olympics up there. There's chairlifts up there. There's a run over there. There's a run over there. Run over there. It's pretty cool. So I just left Christopher Weeks and Richard's house. They fed me lunch, which was fantastic. Took me up on their roof, which you saw here a few minutes ago, on their cool view of their building. They have a very tall building. And they live in pretty much the outskirts of downtown Vancouver, right by Sunset Beach. It's very cool. They have like a 60-second walk to the beach, out there in English Bay. So yeah, it was very fun. I love hanging out with them. They're great people. Another amazing Canadian haunters. So they showed me all the sites up there on the top of the building, showed me where all the cool stuff is, some of the Olympic sites, things like that. So now we're heading to Dovercourt Crypt, like I said earlier in this part. But one thing I did want to tell you is that Halloween is like our 4th of July to them. In Vancouver, they have gigantic fireworks displays. They have all kinds of stuff going on. Everybody's selling fireworks like we do for 4th of July. And so they have this really big fireworks thing where Christopher said for hours, people light them off everywhere, and big ones. And it's hours and hours and hours of, and all the cities do it and stuff like that. So that is very cool that they celebrate Halloween that way. And it is for Halloween. It's not just because of another day or whatever, but everybody lights fireworks off for Halloween. So that's super cool. I did not know that at all. Okay, so I just left Dovercourt Crypt, and I'll put some pictures up. A couple pictures of their front stuff. I don't really like to take video or picture inside their haunts, just because I don't want them to feel like I've, ruined their effect and things like that. I know not really anybody from the U.S. is going to go up there and see this, obviously this year and stuff like that, but there's Canadians. I'm going to post this in Canadian groups too, so I don't want them to, lose the effect. Dovercourt was awesome. I saw it in the daytime, but I can understand where everything is going to be and all that, and they show me lots of all their different scares and stuff like that, and some very original ideas. Not very many home haunters do the spark fence, and they have one in there, and it is very effective. I like where they placed it. It was in a, after a hallway that annoys the crap out of you, and that's a perfect way to do it. But yeah, a lot of detail, inside, outside stuff. It was very well done. So I've heard they're very popular. So I'm sure they'll be very busy tonight, and then Halloween obviously. But yeah, that was an amazing time. So thank you, Mark, for showing me around. You and your team are doing a great job. So we're on to Edgemont now. We're gonna be pressed for time, but we're gonna do it. I just want to be to the ferry by about 5:45, and it's 5:06 now. I've got 7 minutes to get to the Edgemont, look around there for a few minutes, have them show me, and then whew, out the door. So yeah, this has been an exciting trip. So if you're in the Canadian, or in the Vancouver area, definitely check out the ones that I've suggested so far and the ones I've been at. They've all been great. Canadians really bring it when they do home haunting. This trip was mainly about the home haunters, not so much the pros. Even the pros have been good. The home haunters is really where I see the passion and the dedication and the detail. Because they have a lot more time to do the detail. Pros don't have that kind of time. Some of them don't get the space in enough time, where home haunters, you have it all year. So like Brinkworth's and Anmore, and then this Dovercourt is, you know, definitely can show that they spend a lot of time on it. It was awesome. All right, on to Edgemont. All right, so we just left Haunt on Edgemont. Trevor, that was awesome. I can't say enough how the difference between home haunters and pro, I mean, it's just the passion, the dedication, the time, the availability is just hands down, you know, completely different. The different things that he has in there, the different rooms and the transitions, even though there's a bunch of different themes, it still works. Lots of great scare spots, some amazing detail, especially in his tunnel to hell. That was awesome. I have some pictures I'll show you right now of me in there. It was, you know, again, the detail is just so awesome. And he definitely was excited about his haunt, which is great. We are on our way to the ferry now. I guess I have to go this way. Okay, yes, I have to go this way to the ferries. That'll be fun. Evidently, there are whales out in the bay. So I'm possibly going to be able to see some whales before it gets dark. So I'll be videotaping on the ferry while I'm up on there. Here we go. All right. We're going in lane number 2. We're going to get on a ferry. I've never been on a ferry before. Okay, well, yes, I have. But it was when I was a little kid, and I do not remember it at all. So this is going to be awesome. I'm super excited about this. So we're going to go over to the bay. We're going to go over the bay here, this Horseshoe Bay to Departure Bay. And we're going to go to Nanaimo. And we're going to see two haunts over there. That's going to be awesome. And we're going to end at the second haunt, and that's where I'll spend the night. This is exciting. I'm having such an amazing trip. This is like the highlight of my Halloween season this year by far. Other than the exciting, people at my house, you know, seeing our display and being really appreciative of our phase one attempt. I know I'm being modest, but, it doesn't happen very often, so live it up. To come up here and see what these home haunters and a few of the pros are doing, it's just an amazing chance to be able to go see what these what these Canadians do up here. And I, you know, like I said earlier, we all make, you know, not make fun of them, but we all say, I hate Canadians. They're so crazy, you know, and but amazing at the same time. We hate them because they're amazing and they do such great work with the weather they have up here. Some of them have city, you know, issues with neighbors, Jason Oliver, you know, and, you know, but a lot of them are just, they're just another part of the family. And it's great to have them a part of the family. Everybody's been super awesome, you know, nice to me, showing me their house and showing me their place, putting me up for the night, giving me lunch. Chandra's going to put me up for the night. Everybody's super excited to see me, but I'm even more excited to see them. So I haven't stopped smiling since I crossed the border. I'm super lucky to be able to do this. Obviously my wife, I'm super appreciative to her for letting me do this, and my kids, I know they're gonna miss me, but it 100% worth every minute and dime that I will spend on it. And like I said, Christopher Ainsworth and Samantha Black helped out monetarily with the GoFundMe, and so I appreciate that, even though it was a joke. I really appreciate that, and I know what this tour means to Chris Ainsworth, especially, you know, showing that you know, the U.S., my point here is to show that the U.S. does appreciate Canadian haunters, and that the Northwest Haunters Association, you know, acknowledges that you're up here, and that you do all this stuff, and you enjoy it, you know, it was time to showcase you guys. So, yeah, I didn't take any videos inside the haunts and stuff like that, because like I said, I want people to really see them and stuff like that, you know, for what they are at night, and experience them in person. But I'll do reviews of each one a little more in depth than what I did on the videos here. So, all right, we'll get on the ferry and have a good time. So, all right, so we're on a ferry. I'm outside. It's raining, of course. It's Canada. But I'm on a boat. It's super awesome. Look at this. So we just left the Halloween House of Horrors in Nanaimo, run by Melanie and Keith Kirk, I believe, yes. And very creepy yard haunt. You walk through their yard and it's raining on you, and there's all kinds of cool things to look at, and lots of cool little effects, and epitome of a home haunter. You know, just lots of detail again. You know, I mean, it's a broken record on these home haunts, but... these type of haunts are great, and they get a lot of people coming through, and so if you're over here on the island, definitely stop by there. It was very well done, very creepy, nice lighting and moss and spiders and tombstones, very cool stuff. So I'll show you a few pictures here. So yeah, super awesome. So now we are on our way to Chandra's Huards House of Horrors, Huards Haunt. So I just made up that name anyways, but it is Huards Haunt. So we're gonna go there now. We're 15 minutes away, and that's where we're gonna stop for the night. This is the end of our Canadian tour, I believe. I may go somewhere else tomorrow, I don't know yet. Off look on the map. And then we'll be heading home, but we are gonna hit the Nile Nightmares Haunted House. And then we are also going to hit the Cinema of Horrors in Kelso. So both of those will be on our way home. So we'll be home late tomorrow night. That'll conclude our, I think that'll be 13 or 12 by the end. So we'll count them up at the end. But it's been an amazing time up here in Canada, even though it's raining like crap. Stupid Canada rain. I don't know where I'm going now. Okay, there we go. Ooh, I'm gonna stop right here. So yeah, It's raining, but that's Canada for you. That's Oregon for him too. Yep. We're on an island now. On an island. So, okay. We'll report back once we get to Chandra's house. And she has a home haunt that has actors tonight and everything. So I hope they're super excited about me coming. And I hope they got a lot of people tonight to keep them active. We'll head out there and have a good time.